State Attorney Melissa Nelson says she is fighting back against gun violence by seeking longer sentences for those convicted of crimes involving guns. News 4 Jax reporter Janice Harris met with Nelson today to discuss a checklist the state attorney has for stiffer penalties. Denise, this checklist, will it make criminal cases move more quickly?
Well, not necessarily, but it will be effective. That's the goal. There was a lot of research done at the state attorney's office to then determine how they're handling gun violence cases. From there, they decided to create a checklist, and they believe it will be helpful as they move forward with any penalty if a person is found guilty.
Crime is happening in Jacksonville.
The shootings and the homicides are increasing.
In this memo, State Attorney Melissa Nelson defines the charging threshold for gun crimes. It's a new initiative for her office.
So these are checklists that our prosecutors are going to use no matter the race of or gender of a defendant.
Every scenario will be considered. This is an example of the checklist. There are three offender categories. Category one is considered high risk. There's also a checklist to consider mitigators and aggravators of the case. Nelson's office says there have been 79 gun-related homicides in Jacksonville this year. And as early as August, there have been over 300 non-domestic shootings when a bullet struck a person's body.
Why should this change matter to the public?
Is not in reaction to one thing. It was formulated and put together by multiple people after a lot of thought.
Local activist Ben Frazier, who has been speaking out about local gun violence, feels differently about the checklist, saying in part, quote, "One word response to this new policy is hogwash. The overarching issue here is how do we reduce gun violence? Stricter sentencing recommendations will not result in a reduction," he says. He goes on to say, "We must invest more in social programs for the intervention and prevention of crime."
So if somebody is pulling triggers in our city and they're in jail, they can't hurt or kill somebody while they're in jail.
Nelson doesn't know if this will help reduce crime, but she wants this to be a resource to help the community and help her office do their job effectively.
And Nelson hopes that this will be a deterrent from gun violence here in the city. Now, we mentioned those high-risk cases, but there are also people that are considered low-risk. They would more than likely be put in a diversion program. Reporting live from the state attorney's office, Janice Harris, Channel 4, the local station.